Hey everyone, so we're going to talk about two things today. One is ledger lines, sometimes spelled L-E-G-E-R without the D, but I like ledger lines. So ledger lines, and then we're going to talk about a combined two-staff way of writing music that's used for things like pianos, and they call that the grand staff. So first things first, we have more notes than can fit in this five-line staff. So I get a total of 11 notes on that staff, right? So starting at D. And then I run out. The thing is, most voices, most instruments, almost everything can do far more than 11 notes of range. So what do we do when we need a note that's beyond the five-line staff? And that is where ledger lines come in. What we do is just build in a temporary staff line if I need a note above what the five lines can reach. So if I come over here to this G, right, so that's a G right there. The G still touches the staff, right? So we have F to G, so top line is F, then the space above is G. But in order to get to the next place, if I just had a note floating around in the air, it'd be hard to tell how high or low it was. But if I have a temporary staff line on it, then it's no problem. I can see that it's exactly one line up and it's on the line. And then it turns out if I have the next note up, I don't even need another temporary line. I just go up onto the space that sits above this line. And then if I go to the next spot, I get C. So we just keep going up the musical alphabet with temporary lines and spaces. So G, A is one ledger line up, and then the spot sitting on top of that line is B, and then two lines is C and D and so forth. And then we can do the same exact thing downward. So if there's D at the bottom and I want to go below the sound of a D, I put in a temporary line just like before. Oops, sorry. So D to C, and one line, and it's on the line, right? So say that I have a note down here. How am I going to figure out what letter name that has? Well, D is here. C is one line down. Then I can just keep counting backwards in my musical alphabet and counting lines and spaces. So if this is C on the line, the space would be B. The line is A. The next space is G, and then this line turns out is F way down there. This works in both clefs the same way. And you can see below the staff, there's my C, there's my A up above. So it's just a continuous spectrum, but it's too confusing to your eye if we were to have all these lines present all the time. So even though an instrument might be able to reach four lines up and four lines down, we don't write all those lines all the time because then your eye has real problems finding its way through the middle there. So we have a few examples here. So we can see linear above, A, B, C, D, E, and then going downward below, C, B, A, G, F, right in order of the alphabet. And we only write a ledger line when we need it, right? So we never have useless ink on the page. C, D, E, F, G in bass clef. E, D, C, B, A, and bass clef. Cool, and then we have one other thing to look at. There we go. Okay, so the grand staff. So this is used for more than just piano, but the most common place to use this is the piano. So the piano, or the pianist, has two hands to play with, and so what we do is we have two staffs for the piano. One, the top staff will be the right hand, and the bottom staff will be the left hand. And so what we have is this sort of imaginary 11-line staff, and you can see if you take away the middle line, we end up with our right staff and our left staff. And then we can put whatever clef we want on these, but typically the top one is treble because it's the higher notes of the piano, and the bottom one is bass, which is the lower notes of the piano for the left hand. So, and then we have this imaginary middle line that's there. We just don't write it. So we can again this is very confusing to the eye. It's too hard to find which line is this right here. My eye gets all crazy in there. So what do? We take that line away, and then we can really clearly see this spectrum of notes right in a row. So we get a lot of notes with these just two staffs combined. Now, if I needed to play this, it would be left hand, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B. And then what do? Which hand gets the thing that's dead center, right? Do I do it with my left hand or do I do it with my right hand? And I bet my right hand could actually hit that note a little bit pretty easily. It's right in the middle of your body. And maybe your left hand could hit this note pretty easily. So what we do to make sure that the musician knows exactly which hand to play for this kind of middle ground, what we do is we spread the two staffs out even more. So we actually take that line and we just go whoop, and we actually put it in two places. So, well, actually back here, this guy, because it's right dead center between our two staffs, it's called middle C, right? It's not because it's the middle of the piano where middle C is. It's actually because it's dead center in this imaginary 11-line staff. And then in order to make it clear which hand plays middle C, I offset them. So if it's the bass clef, the left hand that needs to play the C, I know it because it's way closer to that bass side. And this C, same exact C, these are both the same note. It's just about telling you which hand to use to play it. And I could go a little bit lower with the right hand or a little bit higher with the left hand, and I would still be able to see, oh, you know what? All the notes around here are much closer to the right staff, the top staff, and then the right hand staff. And then these, even if they're up here a little bit, are much closer to the left hand. And you can see in a score editor like Sibelius that it's even farther apart by default. Often we end up bringing it a little closer together, but it's really far apart right there, right? So you really see which hand is supposed to play what, even though this note and that note sound exactly the same. Middle C right there. Okay, so we add that little extra space so we can tell which hand plays that note in the middle ground, and then a couple other notes can also fit in there and it'll be clear which hand plays what. So then, when it comes to practicing this, we'll eventually get to the piano, but for now, it's just about recognizing the notes. For the grand staff, what we're going to need to do is deal with a little bit of ledger lines here and there, and then also be able to do that shifting gears between treble clef when it's in the top staff and bass clef when it's in the bottom staff. So this note's in treble, and it's just above our mnemonic area, right? So what we can do is still use our mnemonics. Elvis's guitar broke down Friday is the F, and this is one spot up, so it must be G. And great, we got a middle C, and this middle C is clearly closer to our bottom staff, so I must play that middle C with my left hand. Let's figure out, I already said it was middle C, but how do we figure that out? Well, we can still use our mnemonics. So good burritos don't fall apart, it's bass clef. And then we go one spot above apart, so A is the line, the space will be B, and then the next spot, we have to draw a temporary line to get C. And there's F, E, so again treble clef notes. Oh, back to bass clef, C, A. So the tricky bit is getting your mind to shift gears between the two clefs, that's tough. Treble clef, you know, not every good boy does a fine. I hate that one. Elvis's guitar broke, right? B. There's all for all cows. There's that G we started with. And occasionally you're going to get some ledger lines. Let's see if I get one more ledger line in here before I call it. Again, I'm just typing letters now. D, E, B. Ah, same one, C. Ah, okay, another one. So let's figure this one out. So, good burritos don't fall apart. Then I just have to walk one spot at a time. B. So, good burritos don't fall apart. A is there. B, C, D. So, on the line is A. The space is B. The next line is C. And this spot above the line is the space above the line is D. Oh, nice. Perfect. So, Elvis is the bottom line, then I just have to walk backwards in my alphabet to go lower. So E, the space would be D. The line is C. That's that middle C right there. And then one more spot is B. Okay, I hope that makes sense. So use your mnemonics when possible, and then you'll have just a few spots to count up or down away from the staffs, and then you got to be able to do that mind the gear shift, right, between treble and bass, which can be tricky. So just do it over and over again. It'll get faster and faster, and the faster you get, the easier the whole rest of the course is going to be. Okay, good luck, and I'll see you next time.